we're gonna play out a scenario in a situation where if you're a dog owner, I really truly am a believer that you should have some kind of leash in your car all the time. And because you don't know, you know, what you're heading into, we've stopped and gathered dogs up along the way, and so, you know, as I believe that, you know, when we have this major earthquake that's going to hit Salt Lake, we're going to be a lot of ones stepping in and kind of guiding and directing and helping, and most likely we're going to have a lot of dogs in our yard. I mean, it just is just kind of, you know, wherever we're going to get them to safe places and do the right thing. But it's important to have your dog trained and to be okay, because if your dog's so afraid of everything, then it's just going to run frantic and it's going to end up biting somebody, and then there's that higher risk of being hurt. So we're going to play this out. I know you guys know my dogs well, but you've never had them in an open, let's free for all situation. And our goal is going to be that the safe place, we have to get out of here, and the safest place for us to get to right now, you know, we're not under rubble, but things are falling, and we just need to get to a safe place. And so I'm going to let you guys take over from here, and whether that safe place is across the street, on somebody's porch, and whatever that is, you're going to play that out in if we have a zombie apocalypse, whatever. Right? Chianti, leave it. And so these two are not going to have leashes on them. No collars. And you happen to have a leash, and you're leashing up the little guy. So you're just going to talk through, kind of work through with it, you know, just kind of team up, and how are we going to control what, because they're going to go out pretty chaotic because they've never done this with you guys. So your goal is, one, not to get anybody killed. And get them to a safe place that makes the most sense, mm-hmm. and do what's the most natural to get them under control. Okay? So we need to get out of here. This is not a safe place for us to be. And let's get the dogs into a safe place.
Okay, let's go. Come on. Let's go. Cora, come. What do you want?
Your mind, what happened?
I mean, I can tell you what I would have done differently to prepare for this.
Yep.
If they were my dogs, which, I mean, it was being your dogs, I would have let them come out that gate more often, probably done a wait at that gate so that they naturally just, like, slow down and stop before they just book it out. Another thing I think we could have done a little bit differently is, obviously, they really like your truck, and if they could get into your truck, that's probably a really safe place for them to be. They naturally went to the cars. 2 day. Yeah. So I probably would have checked the truck to make sure it was open, to see if it was open, let them in it.
I think one thing that I would have done too is we would have kind of communicated like, oh, if they go to the truck, and like did that better. Another thing I noticed is that if like Bora went out and I'd be too focused on him, then Canty would take that as her, like, I'm gonna go over here.
Yeah.
But if we would have just sat here and fiddled with something, they would have come.
Right.
And, oh, this is where the stuff is happening, rather than, oh, this is a game, they're focusing on Bora, I'm gonna go over here. And then Canty, oh, they're focusing. So I would have mentally stayed more put here.
Yeah. So I think that it's, if that was a real life situation, like, we're not prepared for it, right?
It's not right now.
And even if it was me in my situation and this where it was my dogs, that's the state that you're in. I don't know. Do I get in trouble? I don't know. And so, it's really, kind of trusting a little bit that if they're there, maybe I should let them be there, or. That's not the safest place just because that's what they know. Even saying, you know what, one is being the most naughty, so I'm now going to make a double leash and scoop somebody up with the other end of that leash or something, right? Being a little bit more structured in their obedience and telling them to lay down. Not that you would know that if somebody else was doing it, but you would hope that people in general would start throwing out commands, because that's what we're good at.
Yeah.
Lie down, Chianti, lie down. Lie down. Being a little bit more firm about what we're expecting. Like, you can't do this because it's stressing me out and this is already a stressful situation. And so throwing out commands, because that's what people are going to be doing to try and control a little bit more of the situation. But did you ever have a fear or feel like they're going to run away?
No, I didn't. And in fact, I was thinking about if they were my dogs, I probably wouldn't have done anything because they're going to come back. And if you're really in a natural disaster, because I wasn't worried they were going to take off, but
yeah.
If a car was coming down right now, but I would assume that there was an earthquake, cars would stop.
Yeah, yeah.
So I was a little bit worried about them just being in the road for that reason right now,
yeah.
Because there's not a natural disaster. But my dog, I think I probably would have just let them go.
Yeah.
Because I trust my dogs enough to know that they're going to stay in their place.
Right.
So, yeah. In fact, even the truck thing, I probably would have thought that afterwards and been like, oh, okay, the earthquake has stopped. Let's now put you in the truck.
Sure. Yep. Yeah. Okay, let's get him back to the
probably
house.
Probably would be more panicked too, so my dogs would probably be like, why is she panicked? I have to go with her.
Right. Yep. Yep. For sure. And it's not, it's funny because it's not something we think about. Like, we're going to come across the street and we're going to be here.
Right.
And I'll probably never do this again because I don't want him to get in that habit.
Right.
Right? But we should practice. Once a year we should go, what, lie down. We should be at least once a year thinking about what's changed, what's different, where should we be, how are we going to react to it, just in case it happens. You know, the people on the coast, they're going to get hurricanes all the time. We're just waiting for that 100 years of some point to have an earthquake. We don't know. You know, we're pretty spoiled. We take things for granted here, where once a year, if we prepare for something like that once a year of, I got to make sure my dogs are close because I'm not necessarily going to be in a situation that I can grab them or be, but I know they're going to stick with me, whatever I decide or choose to do. And so it's a really good point, but if something happened to me and I'm down, they're not going to go far, but they'll go because they're going to be scared and they're going to have that fear and they're going to do, oh, what's going on? What are we doing? Kind of a thing. But we could also trust the goes, where's your owners? Why are you guys out? And start looking for, does somebody need help? Because there's nobody with them. And so teaching and doing this exercise with the puppy who's never experienced this ever, he's never been out with these two like this in this situation, having a leash on him and training to the point that he was more settled and quicker to connect with you than these two were, because he's more vulnerable because he's a puppy and he had no idea what we're doing. And so, you know, training is so important that, you know, Michelle, you did a post about keep training, keep doing it. We forget as trainers. We're like, oh, it's great to have good dogs. Well, you know, here's a prime example of, maybe we should have done something a little bit different. You know, you got to keep doing, you got to set them up to be successful all the time. And so starting with young dogs, creating that, what's that picture, stick with me, be with me, the leash is on, we're wrestling, everything's kind of a bit chaos, stick with me, goes a long way. Okay, go get in the yard. Back to our yard. Go.